So I get questions all the time. Ken, how does LegendBorne come up with such awesome stuff? Why do you guys have such, like, the best line of clothing in all of obstacle course racing, rugby, multi-sports, and, like, extreme events? Well, I tell them, we're just lucky. No, we're actually, has nothing to do with it. We're actually really good at what we do. We test everything like crazy. And we are also racers. Some of us at the age group, some of us at the masters, some of us are getting the anchor award for coming in last, and some of us are, you know, chasing podiums. So I'm gonna show you a little bit of some of the stuff that we have to do to our clothing lines before we even attempt to offer them to you. You say, Ken, what are you doing with this block of wood? I say, well, we have a new product we have to test, so we gotta put it through the whole gambit of tests. Okay, well, what's this block of wood? What is all this other stuff? Well, you're about to see. First, you gotta put the LegendBorne safety goggles on. Then, get our prototype. This is our candidate material here. This is some of the best stuff I've ever seen, but will it perform? We'll find out. So first, we're gonna go through the smash test. We're gonna smash the heck out of this thing, and we're gonna see what happens. Okay. Alright. I don't see anything at all. Whoa! It totally dented the wood. So I say, smash test. Success at first. Let's try it two times. Alright. Looks good. Smash test passed. Alright. But you say, Ken, smash test, really? That's lame. Why don't you step it up a notch? Alright, I will. Let's see. Right. How about we smash it with the hammer? Ken, you already did a smash test. With a piece of wood, though. Wouldn't a hammer be worse? No? Alright, well, let's try something else. How about a nail? We'll put it, let's see, just in case it actually does some damage, I'm gonna move it to a more inconspicuous place. So here we go, right down here at the bottom. Oh! It's definitely in. Alright. So, it definitely went in. Let's see what happens when we kind of stretch it out a little bit. All right, so we definitely have a puncture. So we know something big like this gets seriously hammered into it, it's gonna make a hole. Now, I've never had anything pass this test, so that's okay. But I do want to see the integrity of the garment. If we do have something that penetrates all the way through it, is it going to affect the overall integrity of the garment? So, is it going to get bigger simply as we wear it and wash it? So we're going to test that right now. That's a negative.
Try it again.
Still negative. That is quality workmanship. All right, so remember, nothing has ever passed that puncture test except maybe like a waterproof vest or something. So, all right, so now,
okay. All right, man. Yeah, but that's not super tough.
How about something more tough? How about a blade? I say, okay, Ken, that's maybe a little bit too much. Let's try the is it gonna catch on stuff test. So this is a wood desk. Now these are sanded just a little bit, so we're gonna try it on that first, just this edge here. We're gonna see if we get anything that catches. We will see. Okay, we're gonna Let's see if anything catches. Let's get that hole on there too, right? Let's see if that thing catches. So, nothing. Nothing at all. Okay, now, this is, ouch. I totally just got a splinter right now. All right, so now we know there's like crap sticking out of this thing, right? So we're gonna see how well it does against this. That's actually pretty good. One thing I did notice about this particular material and this particular generation is it really does seem very smooth. It didn't really catch on much as I was doing my tests. I really like that feature because I have been on obstacles where my clothing catches something. And I mean, that's it. I mean, you gotta like stop, you gotta undo. If you're hanging from something and it's catching, I mean, you gotta sit there while you're hanging and get out of whatever you're stuck on. Oh, that's just a pit. Alright, so this side's pretty gnarly. So we're gonna go by our hole. Just gonna. Okay, so see how it definitely caught on the hole. Yes. See if it. I'm actually. Ooh, there we go. Whipped a little bit. Just a little bit. And I really tugged on this thing at a great time. That's pretty good. Man, that is actually really good. Okay. Alright, so. Alright. Well, let's see. Let's get near the hole. One of the main reasons I put that one there so we kind of keep everything near there so we can kind of just overall kind of look. Alright, so another thing I want to pay attention to is that little motion, see how it's kind of like slacky right there because we just kind of beat the heck out of it. So we're gonna keep our eye on that because we really hit that thing. Alright, razor blade. This is brand new, by the way. I literally just opened this, like right now. There it is. I have not. I'm pretty sure I haven't used this, so. Alright, so ready? So I'm not gonna stretch it too much because it's kinda unfair. It's like nothing. It's like nothing happened there. Okay, so I'm gonna go kind of like just above the hole and just kind of. So that was actually kind of hard. Like I actually pushed into that. Now, that looks pretty good, dude. That looks really good. I would say that passes the test. Now, this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna take this thing, see how it's stuck right into that wood. This is my wife's table, so I want to be a little careful. So let's get the wood back in there so I don't get yelled at. All right, so there's a hole. Okay, we're going to. All right, so that you can see it. There's a little white, little itty bitty white dot right there. That's where it just punctured and stuck in. So we're just gonna. Little hole there, but you see how it is really strong and it doesn't get any bigger. So I would say that passes the integrity whole integrity test. So, and I even tried to cut this thing. I tried to cut this thing with the blade and nothing. And that's actually quite impressive. I have military clothing that doesn't do that, so that's impressive. Alright. I was gonna say, Ken, it's like not reality. We need to like beef up a little bit. Alright, well, we'll do it.
He's got a fresh batter in this hog. Oh yeah, baby.
So, this is also brand new.
Safety lock. We're gonna slap this baby in there.
See some teeth bit through, not bad. Nothing. That is solid. You're not gonna get that anywhere. So if you ever have an obstacle with a sawzall in it, you know that it's not gonna mess up your day. All right, this round of punishing on the LegendBorne new generation is over. I'll see you.
So I hopped in the pool, I did a 100 yard freestyle for time at about 110. Then I did a freestyle 500 for time with a drag suit on. I then did a 500 for time freestyle at about 7 minutes. I then hopped in the pool with the jersey and did another 500. For time. This wasn't all out, but it was hard. It mimics what I would do in a race. So the whole thing mimicked what would happen in a race. My upper body was quite tired. I did full workouts previous to this and the day before. My upper body was pretty spent. My normal 500 time is in the 16s and 620s, and these were significantly slower. As you can see here in the chart, between the two sets, the 500 for time without the jersey is in green, the 500 time with the jersey is in red, and you can see this 500 with the jersey is only 16 seconds slower than the time without the jersey. And this had a drag suit on, so kind of replicated having, like, you know, shoes and regular that's here. I even did a 100 butterfly after that at about a 118 pace, which is not bad, my 100 butterfly. So of course I had to conduct the most important part, which is the weights and balances tests, where I conducted the back lever, some human flag pulls, and of course the flip tests. No, actually these weren't the actual weight and balances. The real weight and balances were actually very interesting. If you look at the top center, that is the prototype jersey throughout this whole video, coming in at 211 grams. If you look at the top right, that's Generation 8T, that's not a jersey, 157 grams. Top left is what my wife tested, the female racerback medium, coming in at 152. The bottoms are all these either freebies, or in the center bottom is a sleeveless workout top that I wear. So you can kind of see here where a high quality LegendBorne tee in the top right weighs only about 14 grams more than what you get at a Savage Race finish line. At OCRWC finish line, the female racer back is less than 20 grams heavier than that. And the Generation 10 comes in at 211, and you're going, Ken, dude, look at that. It's like, you know, 60 grams, dude. You know, that's crazy more than the females. And you know, like, way more than what I would find somewhere else, man. Well, this is my answer to you, is it's actually not that much. One little gel pack equals the difference between what you get at a finish line and our high-quality Generation 10 that we're about to roll out. So the verdict is, this kicks ass. This is very important to us because we have the most kick-ass customers on the planet. Find your legacy. LegendBorne.